I had nothing else to do, so I really wanted to be here. Then nothing else to do beforehand. Sounds great. But they really wanted to be here sounded great, so that's good. That's good. Where is... Right here. All right, guys, you ready for the recap? So we're about to jump into... Okay, so there's a chapter 12 behind closed doors, as we see, but then there's a finale, right? So it doesn't say chapter 13 finale. It just says finale. So it makes me believe that it's something pretty short. It's maybe not the full thing. Maybe it's just a cutscene. I don't know, right? So with that being said, this could very well be the final chapter. We're about to get a recap of the whole situation, everything that's gone on with the game, and what we're prepared going into the end here. Yeah.
The Matsugane family and the Mole mount an assault, and the Kamurocho ambitions of the Kyure clan crumble. Betrayed by his inner circle, Hamura becomes a target himself.
This part was sick.
So he reveals to Yagami the Mole's true identity. He is Kamurocho's organized crime division detective, Kuroiwa.
The cop. The cop is the killer.
The man who took Matsugane's life falls under the shield of AD9's powerful benefactors.
The person that is supposedly fighting to protect everyone is actually the one killing everyone. He works
they
as
held
a hired
his funeral at Tojo Clan headquarters.
The money was good. Sad.
An intimate service. The Matsugane family would have passed to Hamura, but with him missing, it was all but dissolved.
I knew, yeah.
It wasn't like he'd made much of an impact on the Tojo brass to begin with. But to Genda Sensei, he was an old friend of over 40 years.
See, that's fucked up.
And then there was Kaito-san, who joined up after finishing middle school. And Higashi, too. When Kaito got expelled, protecting the boss became his personal mission.
You know what he's being. The crazy thing is
all of us
that guy
knew
could
exactly
totally take
who was responsible for taking him from us.
The shit we saw him doing, he's incredible. The mole, the crop, the
cop. It's
just
a matter of finding the proof.
He is dangerous. These freaking guys are the ones that are paying the bills. It's all about the game, basically. Gist of the game, the story behind it all, when it's all broken out, big spoilers, guys, so plan on playing the game later, cover your ears or whatever.
Shintani's dead, killed by
it all really comes down to a medical
this is the pre-trial
facility wanting, or
case.
At least a group, some scientists
basically,
wanting to create a drug
hammer out the flow
to help
trial.
All Alzheimer's disease,
for the jury,
but
now.
They are resulting
according
to human
law,
testing.
Both the
in order to do human
the
testing,
have to submit
they they're like covering it up
court.
As like gang assassinations, so no one really
like
delve into
movies.
It, right? We've and so, for a while now. Turns out we'll this goes to the top, man. Like the head of
in
the,
other words,
the
we need to make sure
the
all
police division
are in order.
Is involved.
Then show
the head of
the
Ministry of Health is involved.
The rifling marks on the bullet are unshakable proof of guilt. You really want to plead innocent with such a severe disadvantage?
How does the defense respond?
Everyone's invested. There's
you
so much money and everything
for a lesser
involved.
Sentence, if you so desire.
It's a lot of people
no,
are dying.
We still contend that Detective Ayabe.
A lot
was
of people are dying
up.
To keep secrets.
Our stance remains unchanged.
Truth got out, then the program would be shut down. The cure or
seriously?
Whatever,
or, yeah. So it was Kuroiwa all along. Everything makes sense now.
Were there ever any warning signs?
Nah. This might have nothing to do with it, but I heard a story about the guy once.
Go on.
Back when he was starting out, his boss on the force was working as a Tojo clan go-between on the side. In exchange for kickbacks and whores, of course. Kind of shit you see every day in Kamurocho. But one day, that boss went and threw himself off a roof. Right when they were gonna haul him in, too. Guess some goody two-shoes on the force went and ratted him out.
One of his own co-workers? Was it Kuroiwa?
No. Funny enough, they found the snitch with a noose around his neck just a day later.
So it was a double suicide?
What the hell? From what I've heard, it's possible that hanging was actually a homicide. Maybe, just maybe, someone wanted revenge on the snitch. After the dust cleared, a new dirty cop had risen from the ashes, with his boss's connections and then some. He's been in bed with the Yakuza ever since. Turns out this guy's our top detective, too.
And you're saying that's Kuroiwa?
Hey, I'm just telling you what I heard. You're the one who asked about warning signs.
Let's split up, Bushnell-kun. Sticking with me is just gonna put you in more danger.
Come on, I'll be fine. I'm not a little kid.
Him being alone is gonna put him in.
I know that. Either way, I'm down for today.
They should do the buddy system.
Okay then. I'll see you around, Yami-san.
24/7 buddy system. Harry returns to the detective agency. I don't see any side quests, even though I said I wasn't doing them. I don't see any side quests outside of the date that one gypsy lady placed, like, forced upon us. He's got a gun. We're at the end of the game for sure, because now they have people in this that have guns. That's fucked up. Yo, what's happening, Amber? What's shaking, man? Getting near the end of this. Dude, all these people on the street, so this is just a random encounter, but these guys are beefy, and one of them had a gun. That's crazy. That is crazy. Gotta finish him. That's good. Good. I did, Amber. I saw you went with the
really,
blue.
Guys?
That's pretty cool, man. It's pretty cool. Looks nice. It's good.
Yagami-san.
Hattori?
Hello, Ty.
Someone's got eyes on your place. Smells like it does
when a
journalist
takes
out a shit.
This guy's a little snitch. Fuck this guy.
How can you tell?
I have a nose for these things.
So?
Screen?
What do you want?
Not me.
Maybe the light was
hidden. Kajihira. He needs to know what's up with your investigation. Honmaruen's burnt to a crisp. Shioya-san's dead. The chairman is very interested to know what happened.
No surprise there.
I would call it turquoise. That's when I looked at it, the first thing that came to mind was turquoise. But you're right. I guess it is
nice
more like
work.
A green. I see.
A police detective cum serial murderer. If you're telling the truth, there's a trail of death following 89 every step of the way.
It all leads back to the human experiments. The patient Shono killed, Waku-san, Emi Terasawa, Hashiki from the ADDC, Shintani, every single one of them.
Maybe so. But without evidence, This is nothing more than a well-crafted hypothesis.
Believe me, I know that already.
All right, I've heard what you have to say. But Chairman Kajihira still wants to meet with you.
I just told you everything I know.
I spent the morning playing Fallout with my brother.
I'm little more than a messenger.
He's working like swing, and if I refuse, like hours changed.
Listen, he's working late. Son.
We're gaming in the morning.
Isn't your enemy.
Sometimes the evening, you know, have so, details you wouldn't otherwise switch.
Be privy to. I suggest you milk that for what it's worth. Oh, and put a good word in for me, huh? If you don't mind. Are you free to meet now? You'll need to bring Kaito-san too, of course.
Yeah, whatever, man.
It seems his bullet wound is almost fully healed.
Everything out of this guy's mouth really do know everything. Seems very untrustworthy.
What can I say? Comes with the job. Anyway, grab Kaito-san and head to Kikunoya.
Kikunoya?
I hear Patriarch Matsugane loved the place. Coincidentally, so does the chairman. Goodbye, Yagami-san.
Well, okay then.
Yo, I'm gonna make some coffee. You want a cup?
Hey, aren't you supposed to be recovering?
It's fine. Come on, drink with me.
Well, if you say so. By the way, Hattori just dropped by.
The journalist?
Yeah, apparently Chairman Kajihira is asking for us.
What I hear, Kajihira's in a pretty tough spot right now.
Hmm?
Chairman Koba from the Kyurei clan's putting the pressure on. I mean, their Captain Shioya just got his eyes gouged out. Never would have happened if Kajihira hadn't shipped him up to Kamurocho.
Yeah, I guess so.
First, a couple of their rookies die in Kamurocho, then a captain turns up dead. Chairman Koba's probably freaking the fuck out.
Guess Kajihira's calling us to fix it then?
Dunno. We'll find out when we get there.
We?
I'm sick of sitting around
this
watching
is a trap.
Drama,
it just
man.
Seems like this is a trap.
We're not getting anywhere with this shit.
What?
Yeah, it's time we try something new.
I guess since we don't know what to do to get him,
I'll do whatever
there's
it takes
this, like,
to avenge Matsugane. So
I'm just gonna be doing some random stuff in between.
Damn
know.
Right.
It just feels out of like, what the hell are we doing this for? I don't know what to do.
Let's roll, talk.
Let's eat the free stew.
We going to Kikunoya?
Oh. I wonder if Kikunoya head to Kamurocho.
Let's hit it.
I wonder if this is a new, like a little city outside of this city, or it is. It is. That's awesome. Every game, near all of these, near the end of the game, they usually introduce another city, another map. I know in the other ones, what city? Oh my god, way too many. Look at these guys, they're huge.
Don't give up now.
Oh, double team. He's still not done? There we go. Nice. Dude, that sit out power bomb, that was awesome. Awesome. Yep. I typically don't get to pull off the double teams in time. It's kind of, it reminds me of those old school wrestling games, or even nowadays, when you want to do a double team, one opponent, one of your teammates, or your teammate has to grapple your, the opponent, and then you have to go and grapple at the same time. It's sort of similar to this. You have to use your X gauge when you see your teammate grappling something. Kind of probably should have filled up on... I think we have enough med kits still. I think we should be fine. We should be fine. I'm sure they'll give us some health throughout, and I just have to not be... But if this is the last...
Like, welcome. I've been waiting for you.
Area, that was...
Long time no see.
It's truly horrible what happened to Matsugane-san.
Yes.
To his memory.
Chairman Kajihira, I assume you've already heard about 89?
Yes. Hattori-san told me everything. The incident 3 years ago was a human experiment gone awry, huh?
I mean,
I'm impressed you figured that out. Quite impressed. I heard about Shinpei Okubo, too. The murder you let loose upon the world didn't actually kill anyone.
Yeah. Emmy died at the hands of Shono, the 89 researcher.
I'm not so sure about that. Do you have any proof?
No? That.
If I did, I'd be making you eat those words.
Come now. No fighting. My old heart can't handle the stress.
Hold on a sec. If you already know what's going on, why'd you go and call us out here? What do you really want?
You're sharper than you look. To be honest, I have a bit of a problem on my hands.
Oh, yeah?
The Kure chairman, Koba, has been getting on my case. He wants me to put a button on all this murder business. Not that I can blame him. His successor just had his eyes gouged out after all.
What's your point?
I want you to bring an end to these killings. That detective, Kuroiwa, is behind it all. Right?
What do you take us for, assassins?
I have confidence that the two of you can do what I ask. What do you say? I'll give you a handsome reward.
Ooh, handsome. He says, he's as much a Yakuza as any of them.
Yeah, I think we'll be going now.
All right. It was a joke. Though the Kure clan has been getting on my case.
So you were half-joking.
Right.
The real reason I called the two of you here was to say thanks in Harshki's place.
Hmm?
It must be frustrating for him to look down on this world just to see people say he died in a drunken brawl.
Yeah, right.
But you saw through that false narrative. Once we have proof and crush 89 for good, he'll finally be avenged.
And you'll finally make good on your 100 billion yen investment.
It's why he does what
not
he does.
I care either way.
Detective, he needs to bring the truth to light.
So, Yagami-san,
that was a little
comes
bit of
next?
A thank you.
Well, Ayabe's trial is coming up, right? We'll use that stage to bring the real crimes into the spotlight. That'll also mean lifting the veil on 89.
Oh, boy.
Okubo will be in the clear, too.
Interesting. I think you're still missing some evidence, though.
For sure.
You're not wrong. We don't know where Hamura is, either.
Yeah, you need his testimony.
What now?
If we want to expose the secrets of 89, there's one man we have to chase down.
I'm gonna keep going after Kuroiwa. Stay on his tail till I get a solid lead.
Okay.
You may be waiting a long time, then. He's not the type of man to slip up.
I know. And Rusev just lost in a tornado tag for match. Sure. Say sorry.
There's no other way.
I'm not sure you have the time you think you do.
That's
what do you mean?
But you guys hit the showers, all right? Hit the showers. Tyson Kidd, Cesaro, great. The short time that they were together.
So say connections.
That's sad with Tyson Kidd. You hear about all these other wrestlers that experience injuries and they can't wrestle anymore. But those people experience those injuries at like the top of their game when all the spotlight was on them. Tyson Kidd was on the rise when he received his injury and never really got that spot. People don't really think like. But what? Yeah, that's another person that's kind of lost his career.
Someone must have pressured the ministry to put Okubo on the list.
Yeah.
Damn it.
I like Rusev.
If I don't do something soon,
I don't
I'm
like
lose
Lana.
My chance forever.
If it were me, I'd try going after an easier target than Kuroiwa.
And who would that be?
Look, this is an article of mine that got scrapped.
Researcher murder scandal, millions of yen paid in hush money. An article got scrapped.
Kido-san? Really?
His womanizing ways are actually pretty well known.
Oh,
guess
shit.
He's really cut loose since they announced 89.
Oh no.
Underneath the lab coat, he's nothing but a shameless pervert. If anything, he's the one you should be going after.
No way am I getting into the ADDC, though. Not now.
Then you'll just have to lure him out. That's the only way to get a cautious quarry to leave its nest.
And how are we gonna do that?
Offer him a delicious meal. For Kido, that would be... a woman. A beautiful one, ideally.
Do not tell me we're gonna have to ask Sari-san again. Sari's gonna kill us. He's just true. Otherwise, Ufuyu? I don't know.
Well, that was the last place I expected to get any good advice.
Yeah, he had a point though. Kido might be our best bet for evidence. Evidence that could reveal the truth about 89.
We're gonna have to drag him out of the ADDC first.
Hattori suggested seducing him to Kamurocho.
A honey trap, huh? I guess it's time for Saori-san to do her thing again.
Hope Kamurocho's number one hostess has a few more treats. They are gonna ask Saori again. Oh my god.
Yeah, I'll ask her tomorrow.
That's so horrible.
Well, I'm all out of gas for tonight. See you tomorrow, man.
I hope you don't have to dress her up again. Pretty zoom through that one. Good sorry again. Alright, let's go visit Kendas. So, what's the plan here? I think we're supposed to... We're gonna trick the old man into a situation that he might get in trouble for. We're gonna probably blackmail him with it, and maybe have him testify against Kurala, the fucking mole. I'm guessing that's where they're going with it. I wonder how that'll be. shit, you know what? There's a spot right here. Let's you know, fuck the money right now. Let's stock up on. Did I really just get into another fight? No. Are you gonna try to repeat it? Dude, how funny would it be if you try to repeat that at the Royal Rumble and then he reverses it and then beats you with a yes lock? Get the hell out of here, man. How funny would that be if you... Oh, man. That's a good storyline. Straight murder? Oh, me being the dude? Yeah. But I'm a cop. Don't know. I'm a PI. Private detective. So, I'm a cop. It's okay. I can knee someone in the face if they're a threat. We're gonna stock up on all this food, because we don't know when we'll need it. If we'll need it, I should say. I will do that. We're gonna buy this Jack Daniels, so if we get to an area that has a lot of guys, we're gonna get fucked up and do drunken master, and that like eliminates like four people. I've done it once in the game. It was awesome. It was so cool. So now I'm really okay. Let's buy some alcohol. If we need to do it again, let's buy some of these beers. We'll stock up on the beer. Okay, that's enough. That's enough. Dude. It is Children's Park? Okay, you know what? Again, because we're so far along, let's go visit the bum. Wait. But sometimes I'm walking along and I feel like I have to interfere. Yep, when you're drunk, at least four. Maybe it was more, maybe it's less, I don't know. But at least.
This isn't over.
Yeah, this is a good way to know. No, but you have to know drunken master style. You have to. Kung Fu, it's special because you have to. You master these certain things and use your mastery of it to benefit you in Kung Fu. You gotta master getting drunk. So you gotta be able to get drunk enough but still be mostly functional. And then maybe you can whip some ass. Who the fuck do you think you are asking for protection money here? You asshats, forget this is Matsugane turf. Patriarchs, I think you mean it was Matsugane turf. Word on the street is your patriarch's dead. Sure. For the longest time, Captain Hamura was the man in charge around here, but that's in the past now. We'll be handling the store from here on out, so why don't you go run along now? That's not good. I knew, dude, I told you, I said it earlier, guys. Matsugane family is basically just done. And now we have all these other Yakuza families that are trying to invade on the turf. That sucks. But this was brought up. This is Hamura's fault. This is like Matsugane family's destruction was 100% Hamura's fault. His dumbass caused all this. You should probably, yeah, hopefully not. But yeah. If you do, might as well use it to benefit you.
You kidding me?
I said, shut the fuck up. I swore an oath to the Matsugane family, and I'm always ready to back it up, even with my life. I'm not the kind of bastard who'd abandon his patriarch just because he died. Can you say the same for yourself? Wow. I guess this guy wasn't such a bad feller. on everyone. Or you're gonna get punt. You're gonna get hit every time, but you'll be so drunk you might not feel it. There we go. Hey, do you really want to follow in his footsteps, man? Dude, fuck you. I'll send you to meet him in hell. Yeah, we should help him.
Hey.
Yagami! Huh?
You see, you're interrupting family business. Besides, that's nothing to do with you. It has everything to do with me. What? I never swore an oath, but I've always respected Matsugane-san. He was like a father. I still owe him a lot. So I can't just let these people insult him like that. The hell, Yagami? Hey. Sorry to butt in, Tashiro-kun, but this is my fight. Oh, they say they're gonna be last words. I don't think so. Ow. Half health. Oh, we gotta throw out this trash. Alright, you know what? That was a cool way to do it. Dude, what's happening? Marzy does and dozy does and little lambsy dive. Hey, dumb. We're shaking. That'll teach ya, they say. That'll teach ya. So, fancy Matsugane guy has been rescued, even though his family is donezo.
He's
gotta find a new family. Don't ask me that shit. I could have handled those guys on my own. Unlikely. Okay, his super story is about somebody other than Rachel. Ooh, that's fascinating. That's a twist. It's a twist. I know, dude, but now I want snacks. That'd be terrible. I'm gonna get my title back because my title was long short. Oh. Lost Brock. Right. I guess that makes sense, right? And you gotta get it back. It's just good storytelling, you know? That wouldn't be like, if you didn't have a stake in the match, it's a pretty good match. That's a pretty good match, right? It's a pretty good build. Like, the match before, someone gets beat to a certain thing, and it's like, oh, he attempts it again on the second match, but that guy already knows because he lost to it the first time, so he's going to reverse it, and then he can beat him to his finish. Oh, man. All right.
Huh?
Oh, we're still in this conversation. That's one thing. Okay, I hate cheaters. I hate people that don't have integrity. And hate's a strong word, but like, I really don't like people. I'm an integrity kind of guy. Like, if someone presented something in front of you and said, hey, this is a surefire way, here's a way for you to get something, no consequence, it's just by doing this, it benefits you and it takes from someone else that might need it, I won't do it. I don't care if it benefits me. I've already passed on multiple things. In this world, there's too much selfish people out there that we shouldn't. Yeah, I hate cheaters and yeah. All right, snitches. She snitches. I don't like people that snitch. Sometimes I understand telling on someone, like snitching. I do. I guess it depends on. It would have to be certain. It has to be based on. Sounds like piss. That's the one that's most worth. He's good looking and asshole. God, don't you love that combo? Of course they do, because he's good looking and an asshole. And Exactly, exactly. That's a way to put it. Like, you put you, like, I'm gonna, I would rather put myself at a loss just so whatever I obtain legitimately, you know? Like, I'm not, that being said, I'm sure there's been shortcuts I've taken in the past. I'm sure I've done plenty of things, but, I don't know. I just, when it's very blatant, I don't like to cheat. So yeah, so what did they do together? Were they like flirting and everyone was like, this is disgusting? Because the girl smells like pee and he's handsome? Because that doesn't make sense. I'll wait for the story. Okay, so the girl who smells like pee is like obsessed with this guy. I get it. If she smells like pee, that means that she... Okay, I get it. Make sure she goes out the door at the same time. It's cute. It's that. It's cute. But I mean, if it's obvious, especially like you've noticed, then that's when it gets. You know, it's kind of. I guess it's sad. Okay. You know what I mean? You're her in here. Not only does she, not only, they're like 400 pounds. The one that got really box break. I don't know if I remember the box braid one, but that's a fashion thing. That one would have went away. Not a catch. Not a catch. That's, you're trying to paint a picture. Not a catch. I get it. At some point, people, when you realize that you're not the kind of person that catches the eye of others, you gotta find a different way to catch said eye. You gotta find a different way. If that's what you want to keep doing, you're trying to catch the eye of others, you gotta find, I don't know, have a lot of funny jokes. How about that? People love jokes. All right, we need more medical kits. Okay, well today, yeah, funny jokes, man. You'll get tons of chicks. Chicks love jokes. Chicks love jokes, man. Yeah. You know, to be honest, though, like, girls, they always say that they like a guy with a sense of humor. That's, like, always been a thing. So, to be honest, jokes are... That is probably your best bet. Too bad I'm not money. Well, shit. So yeah, well today she was saying, she went out the door at the same time as him and she asked him his name, so she is suddenly convinced that because he responded and told her his name, that he has a crush on her. And she keeps talking about how much he likes her, he needs to get over her, and it's just distracting her from studying for these, and... ends with me dying. Well, in life, everyone needs a fucking sense of humor. That's a thing that is missing from a lot of people. Learn to smile, learn to laugh, think talk. Hey, fuck you people. I'm in the middle of something here. I don't want to talk to that guy. Good. We're good. That sucks, Tom. That's annoying, but that's sad. That's... God damn it, people.
Oh, Yagami-san.
I don't feel there's such a strong desire out there for a lot of people that they really need to be impressive to others. Like, they have to be something greater than to like their peers. I'd never really seek that. I've always been the quiet one in the back that's just kind of like happy to be here. Happy to be here. Thank you. Thank you for inviting me. Happy to be here. That's the kind of guy I've always been. There's a lot of other... It's just crazy. Keeps like saying this to me like I'm either supposed to agree with her or get rid of her. Oh my god, that's bad, yeah. I don't know what to say, yeah. She just keeps bringing... Oh, man. You know, I don't know, catchphrases that don't actually mean anything. Maybe you can, I don't know if you should say, you know, you're telling me, because, yeah, that's a good one, you're telling me, but maybe, like, preaching to the choir, like, when somebody says something you don't know what to say, you know, I don't know, it depends on what she's saying. But maybe think of maybe just some generic catchphrases that don't actually mean anything, but maybe it's just enough to end the conversation. Double art works on a camera. Oh, yeah. Tell me about it. Nothing to do with it. There you go. I'm going to go. Two in the hand, one in the bush. Yep. Penny saves, penny earns. Yep. Hey, you mess with the bull, you get the horns. All right? You keep that in mind. All right, we'll see you later. You know, just exit as much as you can with the little... God damn it, that's hilarious. That I would die. If I caught someone just giving generic... I'm very observant like that, because I, like I said, I'm one that kind of sits in the back and pays attention. Always been a very observant person.
Sorry, son.
I would always pick up on people's habits, but oh my god, if someone was ever like that, that would deal with me. I've seen people, I mean, I don't remember now, but I know I've seen people do some weird, funny shit in the moment. And it definitely stuff to where when it happens, people maybe hope that no one saw that kind of thing. Yeah. And I only see Moss. Well, did you save the penny? Because you have to first save said penny to earn said penny. I don't know. That one's always kind of baffled me. It's whatever. That one's a fuck. What other good ones? Just hear me out. So we have to convince Sari-san to... kind of be bait for a sexual predator. Hopefully she says yes.
Think you can handle it?
They're giving us, we get to respond for her.
Tell me what it is.
You sure?
This is funny. You can't deal with the kitchen. Stay there. There you go. Glass. Don't. Or loose lips sink ships. And don't throw rocks in glass houses or at glass houses or some shit. What the fuck is that one? Don't throw rock. Confucius say. Man not man with hand in pants, not crazy, just feeling nuts. I won the title. I made Daniel Bryan tap out. Oh, not Kenny Backbreaker. I don't know if I know that one. I wonder if I've seen it like a different. I wonder like some random person's finisher. I'd recognize it maybe. In the living gosh, you shouldn't throw stones. All right, means if you have something bad about you. Couldn't talk shit about others. Oh, well. Yeah, that makes sense. That does make sense.
Yes.
All right, then. We need you to set a honey trap for Kido.
A what?
It's when you seduce a man to get information.
And you're sure you want me?
How could you ask her to do that?
You can't be serious.
Look, we need to get to Kido somehow.
We have to ask.
This is the best shot we have of luring him into Kamurocho.
Don't be ridiculous. Asking her to be a hostess is one thing, but you can't make her sleep with that creep.
Hold on there.
Ty, that one's rough, man. Come
on,
man. Isn't
that what a honey trap is?
That one's bad. That one's bad.
I never said that. You don't have to listen to them.
But yes, the one that you're doing is a real one, which is a good one.
This is probably entrapment.
Not give man a fish, feed him for a day. Teach man to fish, feed him for a lifetime. You can't lead a horse to water, or you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make it drink. Maybe that's a camel.
What? No, I mean, I have a lot of respect for her as a co-worker.
Well, that's enough of that.
Oh no, his Yagami, feelings are coming out.
Sure, there'll be no risk to Sarukun.
Absolutely, I have a plan.
Which is what exactly?
I'll tell you once we get there. First, I need to know if you're in.
If I can help him there. Not a good
idea.
It's
what the investigation calls for.
Sorry, son.
Not a good idea.
I want to avenge Shitani Sensei's death, too.
Thank you.
All right. Then we don't have time to lose.
We? Since when was it we?
This is really what Saori-san wants. I'll do everything in my power to help her.
Oh, just so you change your streaming service, you're saying you're watching
another makeover, right?
Boba Kai. There you
go. Mind if we use the same salon?
Do you know where that all comes
sure,
from, right?
But
I mean, you know Karate Kid, right?
This time, not a hostess.
You know that show is like really? It's a flip.
Think about
and
it.
I actually, and I swear to God, I am right with this. I know why that
alone much more
the reason why this show exists. I don't know if you guys. Can I pause?
And you'll need to dress.
I don't know if you guys have seen How I Met Your Mother, but Karate Kid had been out for a while, right? It's an older movie. Been out for a while. And it's just blatant that who's the good guy, who's the bad guy. Then, How I Met Your Mother was a very successful series that many people saw. And throughout that, Neil Patrick Harris's character throughout the series so many times would bring up how the Karate Kid was actually the bad guy and the blonde guy was the good guy and stuff, right? And then I don't know, basically, honestly, I believe that because of that being brought up and that always being like, it became like a meme within social, like, and within society. And so, like, I believe that whoever decided to create this show and make it happen and put things in, it was influenced by those domino pieces. It's so silly. But yeah. Karate Kid is the original. And then, like, Cobra Kai are the bad guys in Karate Kid. And now there's a series that. Yeah. But I digress, but I feel very confident in that because I watched that show, and other than that show, there's no reason why they would make this series, this sequel in the future, that is exactly, no, it just doesn't make sense to me. So that put it out there. Oh, that one? Vicious, man. That's a Canadian backbreaker? Okay. Oh, and they use the arms? Dude, okay, let's put it out. Raquel Gonzalez. She's got to be my favorite. Like, when it comes to, like, just female wrestlers, I've seen a lot of powerhouse wrestlers. Raquel Gonzalez embodies the powerhouse. Like, she's awesome. She's so awesome. I hope she beats Dakota Kai, but I feel bad, you know, I like them both, but that's funny. Yeah, that's a dope move. Dope move. That's fucked up, man. Just because, oh, Ty, why would Karate Kid be the bad one? It's because It was just a joke. It was just a meme in the show. That's no one agreed with Barney. Barney was the character of Neil Patrick Harris. So he would always bring it up saying like, oh, the Karate Kid, you mean the blonde guy? They're like, no. No, the LaRusso guy or whatever is the Karate Kid, not the blonde guy. And Barney would be like, no, you're wrong. It's the other way around, blah, blah, blah. And so I'm just saying that all of that light that he shined on it, it was all a joke. And it was all just like kind of in a way trolling, but he believed it himself. Because he grew up with, I don't know, it was a weird thing. But that's what I'm saying. It was a meme. It became a meme, and it was such a popular show, and Neil Patrick Harris' character within that show had a lot of different stuff that was constantly on the internet. Silly fucking meme with his whole, like bro book of rules of, I don't know, bro code shit. I don't remember if that was that. But yeah, nonetheless, So I'm pretty sure all of that and his influence with that is what caused the ripples to happen. It's weird, isn't it? It's just weird. And that's from my experience, and I don't know if anyone out there thinks that or believes the same. Maybe I'm 100% wrong, but I don't think I am. I pay attention to that, those weird things, and it's just people are influenced on a daily basis and they don't know it. They don't really realize it. And then they come up with these things later in life, these ideas, and then they think they've came up with them on their own, right? But in reality, their experiences and other stuff that they've seen has bred that, right? That's all I'm saying. But yeah.
Lord, I'm talking high skirts and low
cuts. So today it's $10 for any regular large pizza. Oh hell yeah! And this Friday and all next week. Final talking. I order 5 room pizza. I'll take that over
most as any day.
Oh hell yeah, dude! That sounds tasty.
Okay, I have some things I need to take care of. Can you head to the ADDC once you're done with your makeup, Sari-san? We'll meet there.
Oh no! Okay. What did I say?
See you soon.
We should be going too, Sari-san. Let's get you that makeover.
Yeah, well, right. I've always been, growing up, I wanted to be a psychologist. I wanted to help people. And I didn't really get far into the training. I took psychology, I took sociology. I spent a summer, like a week of a summer, doing a counseling thing.
Here we are,
thing.
Sari-san.
But I was mostly interested in just the way our brain, people, the way, it's just crazy. People don't really think about stuff. I like to think about those kind of things. A few credits, right? I have a psychology degree. Yeah, and he turned as many of his credits possible as he could into his mechanical engineering degree instead. Yeah, it's smart. It's much smarter. That was like a... I don't know his reason behind it, but like as a practical decision, like, wait, what a good idea, right? It's hard. It's a competitive field. Psychology is a competitive field, and there's only, and I mean, these days now, like, people are just, no. I remember back in the day when people would have their appointments. Nowadays, you could literally just text a texting therapist, or you could just get on your phone for when you feel bad. And you don't actually have to do appointments. Like, imagine like what your job would be as a psychologist these days and whatnot. I would probably just went into surveys and just did the more like theoretical and more not like actually practicing, but you know, book shit. Dude, you bought a yo-yo 2 days ago, Ty? That's fucking sick. Do you know any tricks? And first off, are you even any good at it? Because it's fucking hard. If I remember, it was pretty hard. But like, I remember people, you can like walk the dog and the cradle and then the fucking dude. Really? That's awesome. Good for you. All right. So I'm in a rivalry with the mystery opponent. Love rivalries with mystery opponent. And that's how it was last time I lost the heavyweight. Right. Dude, it's going to be him again. Watch it just be him again. Amber, if they pull the same shit on you again, that's rough.
Didn't I already do this when I was a hostess?
Sure, but
an air-salad businesswoman nurse, right? What a weird span of professions you guys are.
Intellectual beauty, classy, worldly.
It's God, fun without. I'm with you there, Kai. It's just kind of cool that there are tricks to learn.
Oh, sorry.
But, it is fun. It's
anyway, I'm sure
it's impressive
be
to be able to just consistently do it.
And if I disappoint
that's the thing, is like a lot of
that's just not possible.
And to not tangle up the string constantly, like to be able to pull that off, like that's impressive. Screw that. Yeah, right, Ember. Oh god, we gotta do it again, guys. We gotta make her look appealing. Let's zoom through this one. Ponytail. She's putting it up. She's just so busy. She's just so busy. She just gotta put up her tail. Gotta put up the tail. This is not our girlfriend. This is our coworker who we have asked multiple times now to use her feminine ways to help us out on a case. And she's not the type of person. She's like a homebody that likes her privacy and this and that, and we've had to dress her up. It's funny. It's funny. It's all in good fun. On top of all, I was an Eagle Scout. No way. And we live out in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. That's crazy. So you guys got the skills to survive. We have been. At this point, we've tricked around. Second to last on the hair. All right, you know what? If Ty has a suggestion, I'm going to take Ty's suggestion. I'm always welcoming your guys' suggestions. I didn't want to spend too much time on it. It doesn't, it probably doesn't matter. So, but you guys got something spouted out. I do like this hair, Ty, and it's funny you bring this up because we almost used this hair on the last time we tricked her out, basically. One day in like 15. Being a high class, it's good. Yeah. Did you ever play Judgment? Oh, I don't fucking know. Something faint? I don't fucking know. There we go. No, no contacts. We're business. Let's be business, all right? Let's give her a little blush. Okay, honestly, I don't see any blush. This is blush. Let's give her that. Do we do deep red? Devil, what's shaking, man? You came in at the right part. We're basically tricking out Sari-san again. Dr. Keto, we're trying, he's like apparently some sort of sexual deviant, and we're trying to lure him, I think, into a situation to where he's forced to testify against Shono, against the Minister of Health, against Kirawa. Devil, here's the big drop, because you're here and you need to hear it now. Who's the mole? The motherfucking lead detective on the case. That asshole pulling the power moves, he's the mole. And he is badass. He's a mixture of John Wick and Blacksmith. Yeah, dude. Blew my fucking mind. Yep. And he there was a really cool scene where he was just like headshotting, like grabbing dudes, spinning around, headshot, like total John Wick. It was fucking nuts. Alright. Black lipstick, purple eyeshadow. I think that's black. Yeah, it's black. Nice. Very goth. Devil. Let's go. I think this is probably the darkest one. But I like this middle one, to be honest. Alright, let's go to the darkest one. Yes, we are. This is true. Yeah, that's 100%. All right. So that's it. I think I don't know if we're going to have to change her dress. I think this is what she's supposed to wear. That's good enough. That's 100% gonna get the scientist man a little bit excited, if you guys know what I mean. Good calls all around. Good job, everyone. Good job, everyone. Sorry, son, looks like a fine piece of ass. Good job, everyone. Hypothetically, this is true. But you know what? This is my theory on that hypothetical statement, is because I feel like people that, you know, goth, like, are more open-minded and willing to go against the grain of what is the norm and acceptable. And, you know, your cookie cutter, red lipstick.
Oh, you're a goddess, Sari-san.
Holy crap, yeah.
Just incredible. That off-limits allure, that mature aura.
Are you going to stop soon?
Sorry, I just get a little excited.
A good hypothetical,
no, I'm ready to go. I can take it from here.
So independent, too. Sorry. Stop now.
I'm here, dork.
Well?
Sari-san.
We're shipping her away, guys.
Yourself, okay? If things get dangerous, just run.
Yeah. To be honest, I don't have very much experience in life. I wouldn't say goth. I would say more rocker. But, yeah. I have experience too. Alright, I'm gonna smoke.
Yagami-san said I'll be safe though.
Well, yeah, your life might not be in danger, but what if Kido tries to, you know, cop a feel or something?
If that's what needs to happen, that's what will happen.
What? But...
I should be going.
Sorry, son.
By the way, Hoshino-kun.
Yeah?
Thank you for complimenting my makeup. It felt nice.
What?
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. They might touch tips later, or, you know, whatever the cool kids say. Hypothetically, of course. You can't say I have experience hypothetically. I have hypothetical experience.
Hold on, sorry, son. Take this with you. It's a hidden camera.
Oh, it's Seth Rollins? Not a bad one. You can beat Seth, though. It feels like when they're the big powerhouses like Brock, they're a lot harder. But, man, like a normal bodied person, not someone like super fucking huge, Seth Rollins, yeah, I think he stands a chance. Came out with Triple H turned me around and punched, oh my god, and then he rolled over the ring and Triple H picked up the title and gave it to Seth, and it was just that fast. Oh god. Did you ever see, basically they did that, but it was when Triple H betrayed Seth Rollins and then he gave it to Kevin Owens. I remember that. Dude, Authority Triple H is like one of my favorite. Like, honestly, people hated the Authority. I like the Authority. I thought they were real cool. So that's where we're going.
See,
it was like
lens.
Basically they were making business moves in the ring, right? How funny is it that you find out that you didn't get the promotion because you just got fucking, you just got a goddamn pedigree. You got kicked in the gut, you got put in, you got a pedigree, and that's how you know, I guess I'm not getting the job. That's my kind of business.
Wait, really?
Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Of course. Knowing how to woo a man isn't exactly my specialty.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley, before
also,
he was
what happens
Triple H,
after I seduce him?
He before he was D-Generation X, before he was
meaning
Rebel,
there will be evidence of a sexual
right?
harassment.
Before he was break it down, you know, before he was any and all of that, before he was the game, he was a very sophisticated, nice posture. Slick back, long blonde hair with a long robe, who would present himself in such a way and come out to very classical music. That was Triple H. Hunter Hearst Helmsley at that point. Yeah. Classic. What word was that, Dom? What word were you talking about? Jesus, Ty. Come on, man. Oh. Oh, yeah, I don't remember. I get it. I see. I read that out of context of what we were saying, so it went over my head. That's, you know, humor. So much of it has to. It's all about timing, right? Particularly reporting sexual harassment and blackmailing him with it.
Think you can handle it?
I haven't been paying attention.
Don't worry. The more perverted things Keto does, the more he'll suffer later.
Yeah.
I'd rather keep his hands off him.
Yeah, there you go.
Possible, though.
There you go.
That'll be on
all you gotta do is just get,
right.
You know. Oh no.
Anyway, you should head in.
I don't know. I was gonna say get in touch with Shane McMahon. Or maybe like a Ric Flair, maybe, and then I'd be like, you know what? I have this guy to back me up. Is you act? I don't know. But I don't think you got anyone to back you up there. Just gonna have to fight everyone. Challenge Triple H to the match. You can challenge Triple H to the match, and then you take him out. Guarantee your spot.
Sounds good.
Welcome, ma'am. Do you have an appointment?
No. I was wondering if Director Keto would be available for an interview.
I'm sure the timing fell on me.
And you are?
A freelance journalist by the name of Shirosaki. I wanted to speak with him about 89.
I'm terribly sorry, ma'am. I can't let you in without an appointment.
Oh, I see. In that case,
don't be afraid to press the issue, Sari-san.
I Director Keto is a very busy man. I'm sure you understand.
It won't take long, I assure you. And I can wait if need be.
Even so,
please, can I at least see Kido-san and ask him myself?
I'm sorry, ma'am. We decline all requests without a prior appointment.
Oh, I think I could make an exception for such a pretty girl.
There's a sexual deviant right there.
I'm Kido, the director of this center.
Compliment her forearms. Because that's not fucking weird.
Yes. My name is Shirosaki.
Shirosaki-san, Come, I'll show you to my office. A beautiful woman like yourself deserves VIP treatment.
Are you sure, sir? Thank you very much.
Tell me about it, Dom. Sorry, I should have elaborated when I said that. Growing up,
not even trying to hide it.
It was always not weird. Remember that old, I said there was a restaurant that my dad always used to take us to. We were regulars there. And growing up, you could never take girls there.
Please come
because
in.
The old men were
wow.
all creepy and weird, which included some of my uncles. So, you know, no offense, I guess, on them.
It is.
But yeah, no so that was just
though
one compliment
get
that
quite a few compliments.
Stuck with me
please.
Through the years. And I said, what the fuck?
Sorry, Tom. Put the camera on the table.
Janet, very good, Devil. Very good.
Really
intercourse,
me.
Please.
I
like that one. I like that one. Yes. I want that one. Check.
Perfect.
Would you care for a drink, Shirosaki-san? Maybe a glass of brandy.
I do that all the time. VIP here. Verbal ignorance performed. Okay, guys. So we gotta catch him in the act. So before we make any decisions, let me do a quick breakdown of what's happened. We're at the very end of the game. This is the last chapter before finale, right? So it's kind of the last chapter, basically. So we've learned that the original guy at the beginning was innocent, who we got in trouble. All right, the guy that murdered his girlfriend after we got him off the case, he's innocent both ways. He never has done anything bad. There's this company, the ADDC, they're doing the drug for the Alzheimer's people, right? They tested said drug. They thought things were fine, right? They tested on the rats, and the rats and everything said, hey, drug's fine. Here, you can perform it on a human. They performed it on said human, and that man died. That's the guy that Shono had to haul out and was the big case at the very, very beginning of the game, right? So, Shono is the one responsible for all this. now he basically tricked Kido-san into being a part of the project. He's hit Kido's face on it. The Minister of Health has been backing this whole thing and supports it. Because one, he's probably a fucking monster, but whatever. There's too much involved. The Minister of Health, he's doing this because he came up from the ADDC. His career and his success came from all of this, and if the ADDC receives shame, it's going to reflect on his whole career, right? So he needs to make sure that none of this ever sees the light of day. So that's why anytime anyone would bring up that they're doing this human testing, they get got. Also, the Yakuza that have been being captured and like died prior to being murdered and having their eyes gouged out and stuff, they were being tested on, and the test obviously probably failed. So they've been using human testing because it's the only way they can determine if the drug's good or not, but they just don't know. It's not great. It's fucked up. They are making the murders, they're covering them up to make it look like, you guys are still going, that's awesome. They're covering it up to make it look like vicious irrational panda is such a good one time. Yeah. That's so funny. Virtually invisible piranhas could be a little bit too terrifying. Very irritated piranha. God damn it, those are always so good. So let's keep going. So they've been doing the human testing. Shono. The mole got involved because Hamura, I think, knew the mole growing up or some shit, and kind of used him for something early on in his career, and then that the mole, which is the cop, Kurawa, he became very successful as a cop and became in a very like good position, right? And then he wanted to start doing assassinations because the money was good, and he knew he could hide it. And Kurawa is a monster himself. So Hamura and Kurawa have been secretly doing dealings and stuff, but finally we caught up with Hamura and we got him to confess. In doing so, Kurawa showed up, tried to kill Hamura, and Matsugane-san, the old man, leader, patriarch of the Matsugane family, stepped in front, took the bullets. Matsugane is dead, and Hamura is in hiding. We don't know where he is, but we need him to testify against the freaking mole. Now, he's just he's a Yakuza. His word probably won't mean much, saying it, even accusing such a man, but there might be some sort of evidence that he can connect, right? I don't know. It's 10, really? That's weird, Amber. I just read that you got counted out 10, counted 5. That's weird. San is a is it there's a lot of difference. It's a respect thing. It's kind of like how we say Mr. this, Mrs. that. Sometimes it's kind of like how we it's like I could have said Matsugane sensei instead of Matsugane-san, because Matsugane sensei, like, if he is a sense, if he's a teacher, if he's a someone that that people like look to for advice or this or that, he's a wise man, you can reference them as such. Genda sensei, I've referenced him as such. He's been referenced as that, but he's the head, he's the old man, the leader of the law office that we're a part of. So it's kind of like it's like a respect thing. San, I think, is kind of just like a pretty basic like friend. I don't know. I want to say friend. Oh shit, Devil put all the stuff into it. I just didn't read that part yet. He posted straight up. Oh, that's interesting. But yeah, it's weird. That's interesting. Alright. That's funny. John Cena. I just read them, Amber. That's funny. It'll probably be a triple threat again. Or a fatal four-way. I don't know. Lesnar's probably going to get involved again. You never know. Maybe it would just be Cena, Seth, and... All right. So, now what we're stuck to do, because Hamura's in hiding and we don't have any real evidence to point at it, our dirty cop friend is about to get in trouble and maybe might go down as the mole. We need to... We're going to defend him, so we need some evidence. We're going to bring all of this into light at the case. And the court case is coming up. So it's all going to be coming into light very shortly. Right now, we need some confessions. We need some evidence. We need something. And we know that Dr. Keto is the weakest link because he's the one that has the skeletons in his closet. He's sexually deviant. He already discussed this. So now, this is where we are. We need to get him in a blackmail situation to where he can snitch. Four way. Yeah. Yeah, maybe. It was wrestling way. Wrestling terms. Yeah, Devil's always got it. and then when I catch up, I miss it. Yeah, exactly. But I'm glad that without reading it, Devil, I was basically correct, I think. I don't know if I was like absolutely wrong or any of it. But yeah, that's cool. That was just kind of my observation. Are completely not sure of the middle of things. Yeah. Oh, go with pleasure? 100%, right? Alright, so, like, right away? We're flirting. I see. So this is our... That's right. I see. So sometimes with these, it's kind of like you get to choose this, and then you choose this, and then you choose that. I don't think we're going to choose these other ones after we choose this one. Oh, yes. With pleasure. I got you. We're flirting. Thank you. Devil's bringing us back into the mix. We're ready to do this. I totally got... misplaced. I didn't even know what we were doing here for a second. We want a drink? Hell yeah, we want a drink.
Well, sure. I'll have some.
Yeah, I guess.
Special occasion after all.
With my ass out.
Here you are. I think I'm going to enjoy this interview.
I'm in 6-man battle royale right now.
Oh shit, see? So it did. So they did bring Lesnar back. I love how they always throw pain in there.
Yes. To the interview.
He's beating me. Yeah, that's a good idea. If you can focus Lesnar at the beginning, get him out. All the other guys will probably help you throughout, that's right? Incredible. Lesnar's going to be the hardest. Cena, too, though. Cena is always one to kick out, and so many things reverse in the AA.
Yes.
I'm with him.
Undo another button, Sarisan.
Oh, my God.
Is something the matter?
Oh, no, it's just... getting a little toasty in here.
Oh my.
Well, yes, I am feeling warmer.
Good going. He's yeah, taking the bait.
Now then, what is this interview about?
Okay. We should not question 89. I don't think we should bring up 89. Do we? We flirt. So, I want to know more about you, or how about you interview me? What is... It's how I want to know more about you, right? Or... I don't know, dude. I don't know. I'm not great at flirting. 89 is the drug that's for the Alzheimer's patients that is supposed to be revolutionary, but... it's murdering people. It's not perfect yet, but they've been working on it for a while, and ADDC is where it's being worked on, and Shono is the one leading the project. Dr. Keto is leading the project of sorts. Dr. Keto is the face of the project, but Shono is the one that actually does all the science. He is egotistic. I don't know where he is. I love it. Love it. Me too. Oh, that part. I thought Ty was saying he was... I thought you were saying that you're egotistical as well. Me too, man. Me too.
I want to know every little detail about you.
You got it right. Dude, Dev was killing it. Dev was killing it.
You're not here to discuss 89.
You're more interesting than
you're right, though. It is all about that, right? Yeah.
I see.
You don't want to talk about yourself. But when it comes to flirting, yeah, I guess so. Jesus.
So, will you tell me, big boy?
Well, there's a lot I could say. I'm just not sure I should say it here.
I'm this guy, right?
But it's just the two of us.
Hell.
You can do whatever you want.
Oh, my. Well, let me lock this door. You should lock the door, buddy.
Work comes first.
Oh, come on, sorry.
Yes, I suppose the real fun can wait until later.
I like how we have the music in the background. To her tits, so we get to change it.
You should get this over with as quick as possible.
Oh, yeah.
Make your move, Sari-san.
In that case...
Oh, so as if it's something of a choice that has something to do with that. Unbutton another? But what about the legs? What about the legs? Oh shit, is there a bad one? It's the breast, isn't it? He's into the boobs. He's a boob guy. It's the button. Yeah, that's what Devil was literally just saying. And you were literally just saying, they're hinting at that, they're telling you this, man. This is what it is. And then it pops up as an option. Of course, you got it, man. And you've already got it. This is your date, Devil. Let's see if Sari's gonna score. Or no, wait, no, this is bad. We don't want her to score. But all right, let's read this. I told myself I'd do anything if it meant bringing these monsters to justice. Right now, that means getting Kido to show his true nature. One more button, baby. One more button.
Oh,
boom, Devil. High five.
It's getting so steamy in here. Don't you think?
Jesus. Yes.
This is funny. Up.
I totally agree with you.
Wait, sorry, son. Are you really gonna keep going?
That's better.
Sorry, son. It kind of seems like you're enjoying this.
Jesus Christ.
He's the worst.
Yeah, but this is pretty weird. This is weird. It kind of seems like you're enjoying this.
How's this?
Just wonderful. I think that's enough photos for now.
All right, Sari-san, you're good. Wrap it up.
How did they turn out?
Oh, do you want to...
Oh, well, hello.
This is a perfect backup. Stay strong, Sari-san.
Stay strong. This is so fucked up. I feel so bad for her. Easy for him to say, this is so gross. That's so fucked up.
You've made me a very happy man today.
Yikes.
We have some real fun now that the interview's out of the way. My little minx.
Minx.
Well,
How about dinner tonight?
Jesus, bro.
Perfect. Draw him out.
What the fuck?
Okay.
What is she in Swabass?
Yeah. How about somewhere else? I'd rather stay close by.
Oh, I think I can convince you.
How so?
You'll see.
Pew! Right. Good. You got the shot. Take the shot. It is a good vantage. The window right there. Jeez, alright guys, so we're taking this pervert down. You think so now? Another time? Oh, for the date? I think you're right. Jesus Christ, I think you're right.
You've made me a very happy man today. Why don't we have some real fun now that the interview's out of the way, my little minx?
Is it just me? Or did Sari-san start getting weirdly into that whole thing at some point?
Yeah, she was, it's kind of scaring me towards the end.
Anyway,
You think Kido's actually gonna show?
He'd be a fool not to.
Something that accentuates the breath
under Sari-san's name.
For sure.
Said we'd put it online if he didn't
Boop
show.
Guy.
Guess he doesn't have a choice then. Where'd you tell him to go?
The batting center. Sugiura and Higashi went ahead to keep an eye on the place.
What's gotten into you, man? I don't know if I've ever seen you this organized.
I can't afford to take my time with this. Okubo-kun's execution date is coming up fast.
Yeah, good point.
Dude, they're hard.
Come on, we should go.
They're hard, Amber. Don't feel bad. They're hard. Is it... You don't have to succeed to go... Did you have to win that or no?
Let's hit it.
They're hard. I don't blame you, man. There's the that shit's the hardest. The more guys they add to the match, the... Fuck. The key to those, you do best... Oh, man. Yeah, okay. You do best, I feel like, if you're playing defensive. You're just running away from everything, trying to... You want to have as much stamina as you can at the end of the match, I think. And so it's best just to try to avoid people as much as possible, but sometimes that's hard to do. Those matches are hard, I feel it. Because it's only awkward if you make it awkward. That's not a bad motto. That's not a bad motto, because, you know, awkward things happen, but that doesn't mean that you have to shine a light on it. That doesn't mean that you have to be like, yo, this is fucking awkward. Sometimes awkward stuff happens and it's hysterical. Why can't... Why be like, yo, this is fucking weird? Instead, you could be like, hell, laughing. Ha ha ha. This is weird. You know? That's a different way to approach a situation. Because, yeah. I think weird stuff offers us funnies all the time. It's all about how you take it, man. And also, you don't even have to be that. You don't have to laugh about it either. Some people, if you know someone's sensitive, just shut your fucking mouth. If something's weird or awkward, you just don't bring it up. Don't even talk about it. You know that the person's going to get their feelings hurt regardless. How big of a deal? Why isn't it so important in your life that you have to, that it has to be such a, you know what? It's really all about it. Devil's got it down. It's all about, oh Jesus, we're running. It's all about how you handle it. Well, maybe then take it back a notch? I don't know. Whenever I hysterically laugh, my face hurts. My face hurts so bad. At the end of laughing, it's... Oh my god, my jaw. It's the worst. 10 minutes? Oh man, that's funny.
Hey, what's up?
That's funny. We all have our weird quirks. I don't know if you guys have heard me sneeze. I try not to sneeze, but yeah. I'm a 5 to 8 sneezer kind of guy. Each there time I sneeze, is. I sneeze at least somewhere between 3 to 8 times, usually 5 to 7. And sometimes when, I don't know, I wouldn't say I laugh for too long, but yeah, I don't know. We all have our weird things. She is, yeah, that's funny. Sneezing is a funny thing because that's there's a lot of different unique kind of sneezes, just like laughs, right? There's a lot of airy laughs and a lot of high pitch, low pitch, all this that. But even with sneezes, some are cute, some are short, some are weird, some are so weird. When I sneeze, I kind of cough. I cough sneeze. I'm a cough sneezer, and I sneeze five times. It's weird.
We'll interrogate him once we get there, right, Yagami-san?
Yep. And speak of the devil.
Were you just, like, nervous, Ty? Were you just, like...
Surprised he actually showed.
Were you just like, yeah. All sounds right. Like, that sounded like a nervous break. It sounded like a... why am I laughing kind of thing. Just kind of a... nervous situation. Let's have a cigarette because I think it boosts our shit, and I bought all these cigarettes, so use a smoke. I'm just talking or something. Were you trying to make your friend look like a catch? Like he was really funny? So then you're pretending to laugh.
Holy shit, that was the most funniest thing I've ever heard!
Nothing like that. Hmm.
Yeah, man, I don't know, man. I feel like we should eat something. I feel like we're gonna get into a fight. Some ramen. Seaweed. Low calorie soup. This looks spicy. Like a stir fry. Let's just go with the kimchi. This would be spicy. Let's go with the kimchi ramen. That'd probably be pretty good. I think that'd be real good. Let's eat up all this shit. Nom, nom, nom. Oh, all right. We're adding a little bit of that squid yakisoba. I don't know. I'm okay with squid. I'm okay with yakisoba. I've never ate them together, but I guess if I'm okay with both of them, I don't see why not.
What are you doing here?
This is spicy meatball.
Not sure what you mean. My agency is just a couple blocks away. It's strange to see you here, though. What brings you out to Comrade?
In the matter of... Yeah. That's... Yeah, for sure.
Maybe meeting a seductive journalist?
I understand now. You're the ones behind all this. What will you do with that video?
Nothing, if you give us what we want.
What is it, money?
No, we're after something else entirely.
Evidence.
What are you going to do to me?
We're just taking you for a little trip.
We're gonna ask you a question.
No, I'm afraid you're not.
I knew it, that's why I ate all that ramen.
You forget, I'm a powerful man.
What, you're supposed to be on a date assholes. Right now.
Health ministry thugs, if I had to guess.
Do they have them all over the city or something?
Delete that video, Yagami!
No can do skis. Dumbass. Kido, go to sleep! Alright, Kido-san is defeated. Now it's time to whoop some ass. Ow, who hit me? Ow, who did that? Oh my god. I'm throwing this guy through the window. Oh, I threw it the wrong way. You're going through the window. Nope. You're going through the window. Hell yeah, he's outside. Oh, hell yeah. Go visit your buddy. Whoa. This is awesome. No running from fights. Oh, you know what? That's fine. I can dig it. I can dig it. No more running from fights, guys. We got it. This is the end of the game, and it's all badass. Fucking Yagami. Till the end. We ain't afraid of nobody. Oh, we even have Higashi with us and Sugira. Dude, this guy, hardcore man, he's very strong. Look at Fukuda up here. Hey, what the Fukuda you doing? Wait, that's not right. What the Fuku doing? Nah, that didn't work. Whatever. You guys saw what I was getting there.
Stay back. Don't come any closer.
Oh. What you gonna do now?
Look where all that power got you. Nobody's running to help now. Not the ADDC, not the Ministry of Health.
Yeah.
I've been waiting a long time for this moment.
If you kill me, think what will happen to 89. Their research will come to a screeching halt!
Don't worry. Nobody's killing anybody. But I suggest you learn a little humility. I never said I wouldn't hurt you.
Yeah, let's kick his ass. This guy's a piece
Come
of
on.
Shit.
We're out of here.
He's responsible for, or he's part of it. He's part of it. Yeah. I understand that not everybody's the ones getting their hands dirty, but that doesn't mean that if you're hanging out with those people, you're supporting those people, you're paying those people, you're buddy-buddy with those people, why aren't you also to blame?
Man,
partially,
it's
at
been
least.
A while since I did something like this.
This is weird.
Feels good getting back in the groove, you know?
You always did have
yeah, right? Stripping him down. It might be more so in a very, like, humiliating manner, it looks like now.
Bullshit.
We're gonna hurt his
scientist,
career.
Doctor, whatever.
Listen here. It's not too late for you. But if you don't release me...
You'll have your assassin hunt us down?
I'll take extensive legal action against you.
Okay, well, that's actually legitimate.
Who knows what would happen if you did that? I might accidentally let that video loose to the press.
What?
Yep.
If that doesn't sound good to you, start talking. You're gonna tell us everything you know about 89.
This is what makes private detectives, PIs, different than police. Because we have ex-Yakuza, current Yakuza, street thief, detective. Let's see what everyone has to say.
Hey, remind me what we're trying to get out of him?
Where we can get proof of the 89 experiments. Whether or not we actually get that proof depends on us.
This is gonna be us. We can take just turns heading out to grab food.
Kill you. Oh, that's what the movie? Oh, fuck, man. I don't know, man. I'm not really good with that stuff. I feel like my brother, he's really good with quotes and stuff like that. I might know it, and I might even remember the scene, but I don't think I'm going to be able to guess. Does anyone else know that one? I'm not going to kill you, just going to hurt you really, really bad. And to be honest, I might have said it wrong. They might say it in a certain cadence. That would be more telling of what it's from.
What do you people want?
Show those guys at the batting center.
Well,
you mentioned how powerful you are. Did you hire them to protect you?
Out with it already.
You guys see the stretch marks?
Quit acting.
In his upper. I think that's what I saw. Show his fucking body again, please.
You've made me.
God, I need to see those details.
We have some real fun now that the...
I hate him, though, Devil. I hated that.
My little minx.
I remember that, because he says, really, really bad.
Turn out to be some
yeah,
crazy
son
asshole.
Of a bitch. I don't... I hate Jared Leto. I didn't mind Jared Leto until his grill-wearing, slick-back, cane-wielding, motherfucking pimp-downtown version of the Joker. I hate
on the Ministry of Health payroll.
Ichinose's payroll, in other words.
That's right.
Yeah.
I think
I 100% know
yes,
what you're talking about.
Sir.
Yes, sir. Ichinose-san knows I've been abducted.
Oh, Devil. Something popped in. This was days ago, last week. Remember when we were playing Ninja Turtles, and then I said there was this audio clip that... Just it hit me.
Next question.
And it brought me so far back, and I couldn't remember what it was when you asked.
An Alzheimer's patient at the ADDC by the name of
Wakusan
was murdered. His body found buried far out in the
Let's kick shell.
At the time, Shinpei Okubo was
thought Oh man, I think that's like the beginning of like the third level or some shit. But when I heard the fucking game go and then you gotta it has that kind of like that echo of sorts, but not really, but it like prolongs. It's so fun. Such a good soundbite.
What? Cat got
I need
tongue?
To get myself a soundboard so we can have a Let's Kick Shell soundbite.
Wait.
I need to get my shit.
Me,
I need to get that. My bad time.
Yes. I knew.
Who told you? When? How?
I'm sorry. I can't say any more than that. If I did, I... Please, just give me some time to figure things out.
Time's one thing I don't have. Shinpei Okubo's about to get executed for a murder he didn't commit.
They're gonna execute him? Like,
I need to get every last bit of information out of you
right
here.
That shit acts fast.
I'll even resort to torture if I have to.
Torture? You'd break the law over this?
What? That doesn't sound fun to you?
Of course not!
Then start talking! Nobody's gonna come help you now.
No way. What?
I'll give you a chance to think it over. You
better be ready by the time I come back.
That's funny. It's weird hearing it in such high quality. It's weird hearing it in such high quality, man. That's funny, though. That's perfect. Is that really what it, they have that? That's so funny. So, yeah, it's that level. It's that level when you get there. That's Kido's fucking dope. A broken man. My but guess, it's so it doesn't have that 8-bit sound to it, so it's a little bit off, but it's yeah, it is that is it, obviously. So. It's just so Maybe clean about you to it.
I'm sure giving Kido that's some so time to stew the original? And make him realize right, talking is the only option. We'll keep an eye on him in the meantime.
That one, thanks, this Akira. Is it. That's the sound.
I appreciate it.
Hey, even yeah, a guy like
that's
you
what I know,
because
it's that echo.
You've been up and out all freaking day.
How it prolongs. It's like, it kind of like blend. It's so weird. It's such a weird distortion, kind of. Oh, fuck yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, I definitely need that. I definitely need a soundboard. I don't need a soundboard, but I want a soundboard. Hey, Ty, so you were watching that. Mind breaking down what was discussed? Oh, Kingsman 2. That shit's good, man. I think, let me just double check that. That's right. Yep, that's what I thought. That's some good shit, dude. What a cool couple movies. Those movies are legit. Kingsman movies. I was very skeptical when those first came to like the trailers and stuff. I said, man, I don't know about this, dude. Those movies are fun. Yeah, Devil, that would be awesome. That would be really cool. I just need to. Oh, fuck it, Doug. Oh, we're gonna bottleneck him, looks like. Oh, we can't run from any fights, too. Fuck it, Duck. I almost just ran from the fight, too. So, after this fight, I don't know what it said we had to do. We have to go in here. They have us outside when we're doing it. That hallway is like a bit. I wonder if they're gonna have us teleport. No, we're still in here. That was really interesting. First time I feel like I've experienced something like that. Come on, sucker. Yeah, I mean, you got a good series of movies when you care about the characters enough, they kill one off, or many, I guess, but some of them, a lot of them are bad, who cares about that, but, yeah, it's just interesting, it's great, it's fun, really, yeah, well, excellent. Oh shit, this one's in here. The movies are
what a waste.
For sure. Especially with the effects there. They're kind of twisted humor. It's great. It's this fun.
Ready to talk yet? We're waiting.
Yes.
3 years ago, Shono killed a patient by experimenting on him with 89. When did you find out?
Right after the press conference.
The one where we announced AD9 to the world. Shono told me himself. Just thinking about it makes my blood boil. Even after all this time.
I think I'm gonna add the original Ninja Turtles playlist to my Spotify. I got this Final Fantasy, like, long Final Fantasy, like, I guess I should say it's more like old game music, 8-bit, and not all 8-bit, so it's old music.
I have some concerns about 89. At the moment, Ninja Turtles is such a good one. It's
good soundtrack.
I'm well aware of that, yes. But I'm confident it will work on humans, too.
No. I'm afraid you're mistaken.
What's this now? We just had a fantastic conference. This is no time for doom and gloom. Just sit back and try to relax. You deserve it.
I wonder if I can find the original sound.
Oh, and by the way, Ichinose was thrilled with what he saw. One day, the next we have a massive budget. And if you can make consistent progress, AD9 will head to clinical...
At this stage, I'm afraid clinical trials would be inadvisable. If we try, all the test subjects will die.
Are you sure? How can you say that with such confidence, huh?
Because he's already seen it once, homie.
Shinpei Okubo was actually innocent.
What? Ooh, this is when he came
innocent?
Clear.
Why are you bringing this up now?
The court ruled correctly. Waku-san, his murder didn't play out like you think it did. The real cause of death was none other than 89.
What do you mean?
That murder was... It was a secret clinical trial for 89. I gave him the injection, personally.
You did what?
Please, I...
This is good.
I had to take this opportunity. The whole world is waiting for this cure. But when I injected him, he let out the most horrible scream.
Why would you drink? Oh, come on, man. Why don't you put that
his
shit down
hands
first?
Covered his mouth. I tried to make him shut up.
Which means you... You're a murderer. How could you be such a damn fool? What are we going to do? Shono, I just spent the entire afternoon talking up your drug to the press. With my goddamn name on the research.
If you hadn't held that press conference, the ADDC would have been done for and you...
Why didn't you tell
they
me this before?
They got themselves in a pickle.
I needed you, Dr. Kido. I couldn't let the center get shut down. The AD9 project would have been terminated. But you know... This has been my entire life's work, ensuring that AD9 would save the world.
This whole thing is preposterous. I'm going to the press.
There's no need for that.
Huh?
Don't you understand, Director? As long as we finish AD9's development...
He won't use it. He won't use it. Won't He's just trying to scare issues. You. I don't know. He might use it.
Your name will go down in history as the man who saved the world. Not to mention the money. But if you really insist on revealing the truth, both of our careers would go down the drain. And you have more to lose, Director.
Shono, you're mad.
Oh, nice. Well, that's interesting. You have good guys versus bad guys, but it's gonna come down to just one. You know, it's gonna come down to just one champion. So everyone's helping each other out now. But smart bet would have just been letting Triple H take you out. One less guy. Those other guys have to worry
Shono
about.
Told you?
There's gotta be more. Waku-san wasn't the only person Shono killed, was he?
No. He needed Shinpei Okubo to take the fall. And murdered Emi Terasawa to accomplish
Shono.
That.
Shono.
You did not! Hey!
Fuck that!
Save it, Sugiura. We're not done yet.
It's a humiliation tactic, Amber. We gotta... It's all in the process of interrogating him. We've got to make him feel as low as possible, so... I don't know, he'll spill the beans. Just so he doesn't have to feel that low anymore. Yeah, Ty. So, they tested on the rats, right? They tested on the rats and the drug said, hey, yeah, it's good. Good to use. So they did a secret trial for humans before they did the real trial on humans. Because the real trial on humans, they probably would have injected multiple people in the light of society. People would be aware of the situation going ahead. They wouldn't have been able to keep it under. So it was smart for Shono to do a secret one. But the secret one did show that the drug, it just straight up murders individual. This drug is supposed to manipulate and fix your chemistry in your brain, right? And so I can understand how it could be risky, right? How it's probably not very easy and how the shit can just instantly kill you. So with all that in mind, they found that they had to keep doing human testing, but they just couldn't, they knew that some people were going to die before people stopped dying. That they needed to, keep it under wraps. Yeah.
What happened next, after Shono killed Emmy?
Don't you already know?
You had Hoshki murdered.
I didn't. It wasn't me!
The brain is so crazy. So, yeah. So, I can understand how...
You and
maybe
Shono didn't like that
too
much.
Yeah, just instantly,
But you needed some help to take care of him.
It's Shono's life work.
Someone else who wanted to protect 89. That person was...
Minister? The man Shono and Kido asked for help in protecting 89. That man was the Minister of Hell. Ichinose, the Ministry of Hell.
Ichinose. From the Ministry of Health.
Because his career was built from the ADDC.
Made it a place all the old guard ministry execs could retire to.
Yes. Shono and I went to Ichinose-san and pleaded with him to help us. After all, he's known for being well-versed in political matters, both above board and otherwise.
Yeah, and Ty? I'm a firm believer that we don't understand the brain completely.
About
I definitely think there's a lot of mystery still there.
About Emi Terasawa. Every last detail. Without hesitation, Ichinose-san agreed to help us.
I know people have their theories and stuff, but...
According to him, protecting AD9 was top priority.
It's hard to say that, it's just this.
Hence, why he decided to silence Hoshki. Ichinose-san knew he was Kajihira's spy from the start, and acted accordingly.
Meaning he's the one who first dragged Hamura and Kuroiwa into this bullshit. Real barrel of fucking monkeys.
With Hoshki out of the way, all that was left for us to do was complete 89. But we realized something. If we entered clinical trials and another patient died, our dream, too, would be dead. The ADDC would be no more. And all our sacrifices would have been for nothing.
Your sacrifices? How can you say that with a straight face? You're not the ones who died for some bullshit drug!
Go on.
Through all my hesitation, Shono
I think
kept
the thing behind all of that is that the robots figure out he said shit.
We couldn't be
or,
afraid
like,
of failure if
we build
really
the robots and then the robots get they figure out how to become self-aware on their own.
Succeeded.
Like, we don't program in them. And I understand that robots can't do anything without the programming itself, but that's the scare of it all.
Was to keep conducting
that's why it's a science fiction
secret.
Type thing.
Shono was adamant about that.
Why?
think about it, if we could hide the fact that our sons
are dying. But yeah, so in reality sense, breaking it down like that, it is good. It is, you're absolutely.
Despite the risks.
Robot Ripple.
To do so, we needed a way to quickly procure and discard test.
I don't know
subjects.
If it would be an ending though. I think people with could that, fight back against
it would
the
only be a matter of time until AD9 was complete.
It's all with the nuke and then nukes.
And those
I guess.
Test subjects.
Yeah, I don't know, maybe not. Then.
Ichinose-san listened to every single one of Shono's requests. My only role in all of this was obtaining the funds required. And so, money flowed into the ADDC from the Ministry of Health. Money which I gave to Shono, allowing him to build a secret lab in Kamurocho.
The secret lab is where Hamura... And the
it's
mole
where he carries out all of his human
delivers these people, these test subjects. IBM's bots. Oh, it's an AI. That's crazy. So yeah, AI dude, that's so crazy. I don't know anything on Watson, but I bet it would probably cause nightmares. Yo, did you guys ever see Ex Machina? I know it's something kind of different. It's a Turing test movie, but that movie what was Dahmer saying earlier? Hypothetically, I was on shrooms when I saw that movie, in my room. In the basement, in deep hallway, dark hallway. That shit was fucking scary. Because that movie had a lot of dark hallways, like long hallways in rooms. And that shit was scary. I'm gonna mention a secret lab for doing the human experience back at Hot.
Where exactly is this lab? I'm not sure of the specific location. I try not to come between Shono and Ichinose-san unless absolutely necessary.
Well, I think it's because most I don't know if you've heard this, but everything in the universe can kind of be broken down into math, and with math, that's I feel like when it comes to robots, I think they are doing these algorithms. And because it's a robot, it can process these algorithms, this science, this math, all this and that, faster than human brains or anyone. Like, they can do shit in just seconds so much, right? And so that they're able to get these really quick advancements in technology and whatnot, and they wouldn't defeat us.
I believe his name was Ishimatsu.
I've heard that name before. He was the middleman between Hamura and Shono.
You think so, right, Devil? Right, or like, yeah, if it's just when it's broken down, exactly. So it's just there's this, like, let's call it, I don't know, I'll call it the X factor. There's just this unknown, it's just so, in a way, mystical, to me, at least.
Apparently,
it's science.
You'll be in tonight.
Science is magic, man.
Wait,
it really is. Most of the time, science is just magical,
that's
man.
That's where they oversee Shono's
the crazy
lab.
Shit that makes that.
Nobody knows the office.
This is
there.
This because of whatever, and it's just like that.
The sign out front even
crazy.
Has a different name.
They really got a place like that?
Well, Ishimatsu knows where the lab is, yeah? This'll be easy.
Just gotta strip him down and force him to talk.
Hold up. I've got a better idea.
Hmm?
First, we give this Ichimatsu guy some kind of reason to go to the lab. Then we just follow him from the Millennium Tower.
Not bad. Ishimatsu himself will lead us straight there.
I think that's a lot of pressure, Ty. You know, your whole life would be...
How are we gonna get him to
what
go?
What motivated you? What you would live for? What you would even want to do with your time? Everything would be different.
Keto here to give him a call.
With so much power?
Huh?
Hanging out on
Say
Twitch,
something about how we're closing
talking about
the lab.
Theorizing with some
him
homies.
To stand guard.
You would probably wouldn't be work. Of any interest.
And what? You think I'll just agree to this?
Is it? Yeah.
If you don't want to spread your little video, that is.
It's crazy, but this is also the problem. Oh, is that a phrase? Oh, that's a quote. This is a problem for like the history, right?
He's in his 50s.
Back in the day, everyone was like, "Oh, witch." She's a fucking witch because she understands some fucking science.
Oh, that's magic. What the hell? That's sorcery. It's just science. But it's science is magic.
There may be photos of him on the internet.
You seriously telling us to just search him?
Yes. Not exactly.
I don't know if I know.
Try looking
folks.
Up Vice Minister Ichino.
I know Winston Churchill said
Shimatsu might have ended up in
those
a
who are not, or those who do not learn from history are doomed to repeat it. I also know that Wayne Gretzky said something. You miss 100% of the shots you don't take.
Mind hanging.
I also know that.
Sure.
What about me then?
You get, you know, the what? Probably a lot of fictional people I can quote.
I'm not good at that kind of stuff, right? Guess so. Yeah. Well, let's head to the Millennium Tower.
How would you have your minions entertain you?
I'll send you a shot of Ishimatsu once I've got one.
Great. Let's move out.
Perform a live-action human centipede play? For your amusement? Fucked up. Leader like that. You'd be God, right? Exactly. So you'd just be like, yeah. Well, I mean...